tough one tonight, Coach, just a 4-1 game. And unfortunately, we've seen it a couple times, and you see it with some guys out of position tonight. They got that 4-run inning, and that just opened the game up.
Well, I think that the game was played in the seventh when they lead off in a 2-1 game. Now they lead off and make an error on the infield, and then we go the very next hitter, we go 3 balls and no strikes.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of deflates you that they get a leadoff guy on because you're facing a guy that does not give up anything. One of the premier pitchers returning in the conference, and he was relentless, 3 pitches for strikes. So he really kind of zaps the life out of you.
I thought Hathcock had a very good start, but you're right. When he got to the 3-0 count, you brought in Crosby. He lost the guy on the next pitch, and it's just been a struggle for a lot of guys out of the pen, especially when one runner gets on base, they kind of exasperate the problem by walking the next guy. And It seems to be a recurring theme.
Yeah, it is. It's like they're trying to pitch perfectly.
Right.
Because offensively, that guy's zapping the life out of us. And and facing a lefty like that's fastball, breaking ball, change, all for strikes on any counts. And it keeps you from sitting on any pitches. And then we look up at our charts in the seventh inning, and we'd only been in 6 hitters counts. We've only been in a 2-1 count 6 times. So he really, I told the team, that guy's really good. He's one of the premier guys in the league to face. The positive silver lining is he's not pitching tomorrow. and I saw this at Mississippi State when we had Paul Mahalom there on Friday night. He beat teams down so bad that he almost won a lot of Saturday games too, because he'd zap the life out of your offense, and you look up in the fifth inning on Saturday and you still don't have any life going. So that's the challenge is going to be we're facing a different guy tomorrow. I guess you pronounce his name Krasinski.
Yeah,
was very good, and you got to play perfect defense behind him, and you got to pitch perfectly when you're going against him because he hasn't given up anything.
He doesn't walk anybody. You're not getting extra outs. He had 9 walks coming in, and he didn't give any free passes up. So you got to go out there. You got to hit the ball because they're not going to give you that. With that said, you had to make a couple of moves. You didn't have Schreitenthal. You didn't have Tubbs, and there were a couple of guys that stepped up. Jake Little, of course, he's always going to be in there, but he had 3 hits. He threw out a runner. Corey Chafin, DHing tonight, had a couple of hits. DiMaggio seems to be swinging the bat a little bit better.
He's really
made some good signs.
There's some good signs. He's made some good adjustments at the plate, and he's getting in the batter's box more frequently, which helps now. And I thought he caught a very solid game tonight. So Damo's giving us what he can give us in that down at the bottom of the order, and he's holding his own defensively. So, but that was the game. We didn't make enough plays. We lose the 1 ball in the it's that twilight ball, and they lost 1-2.
Right.
And that's that. There's about a 10 or 12 minute stretch there, where when the sun's going down, that it's very, very difficult out there. And that that's another run we gave up that probably is not given up in a day game. So, and then Colton trying to make a play, trying to keep the game close there and make a diving play. And really facing that guy, I kind of want him going after the ball. I always tell him that when you dive and miss, I always want to trace the thought process back to. What was your first step like? Was your jump good? If your jump was good, then go. If your jump and he took kind of a tough couple of first steps at a difficult angle and tried to make the dive.
And he's learning out there.
He's learning.
Playing center field. Connor Alexander tomorrow, bounce back time. He's in the limelight. You need to come back. He needs a strong outing.
They're very difficult to strike out. They're very East Carolina does a phenomenal job with 2 strikes. So, the key is going to be. Inducing contact and positioning and defending because they're a tough bunch to strike out. Colton was on top of his game, very good early, and then it's kind of like we're not doing anything offensive. We had a lot of quick innings, and that now he found himself back on the mound quick. It's going to be real important for Connor to give us some quick innings tomorrow. All right.